गुड आफ्टरनून डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून एंड वेलकम टू द बायजूस एग्जाम प्रेप डियर स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम टू दिस बायजूस गेट ईएसई पीएसयू यूट्यूब चैनल। सबका बहुत बहुत स्वागत है डियर स्टूडेंट्स। आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू टू दिस सेशन ऑफ फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स एंड मशीनरीज इन अवर गेट एमएस 2022 विच इज द फ्री क्रैश कोर्स डियर स्टूडेंट्स फॉर द 2 months बायजूस ऑफरिंग टू यू। वेलकम वेलकम वेरी वेलकम to this beautiful platform dear students, and from today we are starting the new topic, new subject for this gate MS series, that is the fluid mechanics and machineries. Come on dear student, join the session and tell me whether am I audible and visible or not. Have some movement in the chat box so that I can proceed further. Come on, fantastic, beyond the barriers, beyond the limits. Very good. Good afternoon Jeevan Prashant. चलो हैव सम मोमेंट इन द चैट बॉक्स सो दैट आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट्स आर देयर हु आर एक्चुअली इंटरैक्टिंग विद मी। चलो जल्दी से आओ। यस डियर स्टूडेंट्स, सो टुडे सेशन, यस, फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स, दैट इज वेरी बेसिक और फर्स्ट चैप्टर, वी कैन से द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ फ्लूइड एंड द नेक्स्ट वन इज द फ्लूइड स्टैटिक्स। बेस्ड ऑन दैट दिस टू चैप्टर्स वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड, वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व द न्यूमेरिकल्स, द क्वेश्चंस expected with the most jiski probability hogi, right, those questions we are going to practice, we are going to solve. Come on dear students. Yes. See, fluid mechanics, when you talk about the basics, okay, like the properties or the manometry or the forces in the submerged bodies or the submerged bodies, these are all common things. Irrespective of your branch, civil, mechanical, chemical, these are the very basic things, dear students. Okay, so there is no any issue if you are attending this session, no any issue. Definitely, it is useful for you. Yes, thank you so much, Jeevan. Thank you so much. So let us start this session, dear students. Of course, for all the branches, irrespective of your branch, mechanical, civil, or the chemical, you can definitely attend the session. Chalo. Yes, this is the very first beginning class. Okay, this is the fifth day, fifth session, dear students, for our Gate MS series. Okay, which is going to run for 2 months. This is absolutely free course, dear students. We are actually running here on the Byju's Gate ESEPSU's YouTube channel. So, dear students, this is about me. I am Omkar, having more than 10 years of experience for teaching Gate and ESE. Okay, definitely, Jeevan, I am going to discuss all these things. Let me finish this introductory part of the session so that we will move on, okay, to the actual things related to the fluid mechanics. Okay, chalo, aa jao jaldi se, join kar lo session ko, like kar do and share this session among your friends so that they can also attend the session. They can also take the advantages of this session, dear students. Right? Hello, Rahul, kaise ho bhai? Manishelvam, yes, this is the very first, this is the very beginning session, yes. Yes, for the civil, like strength of material, this fluid mechanics also, dear students, common subject between our civil branch and the mechanical branches. Okay, there are certain topics are some, say, when I say the flow through jet channels, it is some extra topic in the civil engineering. Otherwise, left or syllabus for the fluid mechanics almost same. Okay. So, little bit question, definitely, this will be, see, again understand. So, whichever, see, I am not saying that each and every point in the fluid properties or the in the hydrostatic I am going to, or the fluid statics I am going to cover it here. But within this 1 hour, definitely, we are going to have those particular topics which are very, very, very important as far as our GATE examination. Okay, those topics. So, definitely, I will tell you which two topics I have raised here in this particular session. And for that, we are going to understand first. We are going to understand the procedure, we are understand the actually background of that particular concept, and then we are going to solve the questions. So definitely don't worry about it. I am going to tell you the first what is the concept, and then we are going to solve the question. Right? Absolutely. Chalo bhaiya. So definitely, see, mechanical engineering actually course is here. So definitely flow through the open channel. Okay, is definitely not going to cover. But dear students, left or things are same. So you are always welcome for the sessions of this fluid mechanics here. Okay, Ramakant, very good afternoon, dear. Good afternoon. So This is about me. I am Onkar, having more than 10 years of experience for teaching GATE and ESE. Till now, I have mentored more than 10,000 number of students. And my area of expertise are production and industrial engineering, fluid mechanics, mechatronics and robotics as well. Just dear students, yesterday I have finished the actually, again, the same kind of course we are having on the Hindi YouTube channel. That is the Laksh GATE 2022. We have finished their production engineering. And from today, I am here on our English channel so that we can have this fluid mechanics, okay, in the AMR series. So dear students, as you know, these are our fantastic faculties for this Byju's platform. Dear students, Dheeraj sir, Chandrasekhar sir, Anubhav sir, Mukesh sir, Sonu sir, Suraj sir, myself is also there. Ankit, very good afternoon dear. Neeraj, very good afternoon. Yes, I am going to start. Just go through this course details. And don't forget, dear student, this is one of the very important information I have to share with you, that yesterday and today, this is the last day, I hope, for this flat 25% of T20 special sale discount is here, dear students. If you want to avail this discount, use this coupon code. Nora Fatehi, oh my god, Nora Fatehi, good afternoon. Chalo chaya, chalo. So, dear student, dekho, aaj ka jo topic hai, today's topic, definitely when I talk about the properties of fluid, so you know that very important property of the fluid as far as the GATE point of view, numerical point of view is important, that is the viscosity, which is one of the structural properties of the fluid, okay. So, this particular law from these properties of the fluid, that is the Newton's law of viscosity, that we are going to cover it today, related examples, very very important you are expecting in the GATE examination, and the second, so I will write here the first thing that we are going to understand, that is the Newton's law of viscosity. Newton's law of viscosity, dear students, based on that we are going to solve some questions, okay. Vishal, please understand. So, complete fluid mechanics in just 5 sessions. You just imagine, if I would able to complete it. So, it is the fantastic thing. But, unfortunately, I can't, dear students. So definitely, dear students, try to understand. These are the GATE. This is the GATE AMR series. So, we are focusing to the topics which are actually very, very important as far as getting the questions in the examination. Okay. So, Arun and C don't actually have such a kind of discussion in the chat. Chalo, and next important topic, see, I'm going to tell you about we are going to solve the hydrostatic force. But dear students, where, okay, we are actually pointing such a topics, right, which are very, very important and quite concepts involved there, that is the curved surfaces, dear students, please understand. So, this is our direct topics for the discussion, Newton's law of viscosity and the forces or the hydrostatic force which is acting on the curved surface. This is our intention. Okay. So, this is our clear actually topics to discuss in this particular session. So, chalo bhaiya, when I say the Newton's law of viscosity, you know that suppose consider the one dimensional flow. Suppose I am considering the one dimensional flow, which is nothing but one dimension parallel flow. Okay. That is in one direction. So, velocity in the x direction, dear students, is a function of y. So, as it increases y, there is an increase in the velocity y. Velocity v, there is an increase with the distance y from the fixed plate, which is there at the bottom. Okay. As you know that very basic assumption of the fluid mechanics, we are having no slip condition. That is the particle which are actually very first in contact with this plate. Actually, they are having the zero velocity. Okay. And after certain distances, okay, the velocity goes on increasing, okay, that we are going to get the linear profile of the velocity, yes or no? And this is, dear students, your one dimensional flow, that is velocity in x direction is a function of y. So here if I write the velocity in x direction is a function of y, and dear students, within this layer there is a existence of the shear stress. There will be the existence of the shear stress. You take the any layer from the distance y from the bottom plate, dear students, and you just check there. So, there is the velocity is a function of y, and there is also shear stress which is existing there at the particular distance y. It is also the function of y, dear students. Yes or no? So, here suppose in this particular diagram, okay, if I take any of the layer of the fluid which is at a distance of y from the bottom plate, dear students, what I will observe, dear students, tell me. So at a distance y, suppose if I take this layer, and this layer, dear students, is actually moving with the velocity v, and definitely what is going to happen, so whichever the layer just adjacent to it at the bottom side, okay, so when this layer is moving with the velocity v, dear students, it is having force f. Okay, it is having force F. And this force is, dear student, try to drag the bottom layer of this fluid. But as you know that there is Newton's third law. Okay, that is every action there is an equal and opposite reaction. So, dear students, the bottom layer is actually applying the same amount of force, okay, which is the frictional force or the viscous force in the opposite direction. In the opposite direction, dear students, that is, this is the same force as the force upper layer is trying to drag the bottom layer with the force here. But at the same time, the bottom layer is giving the resistance to that force of the upper layer with the same amount in the opposite direction. This is nothing but the viscous resistance, dear students. And that particular property we can call it as the resistance to the own flow of the material or the fluid here. Okay, is nothing but the viscosity, as you know it very well. Are hi Anna. So this was very first observed by the Newton, and he found this particular thing, and he gave the relation that this particular shear stress at the interface here between these two layers of the fluid, dear students, is proportional to actually that is the velocity gradient du by dy. Okay, this was the Newton first who actually expressed by the experiments. He did the experiments and then he put, dear students, that this shear stress, okay, the shear stress is proportional to the du by dy, which is the velocity gradient. And if you, dear students, remove this, the proportionality constant, this tau is nothing but equal to mu into du by dy, tau into du by dy, yes or no, where mu is nothing but the viscosity or coefficient of viscosity, dear students. Okay, so mathematically it is a du by dy. Ramakant maximum 1 hour, definitely we are going to discuss. So definitely it is du by dy is the velocity gradient, but dear students, it is mathematically the velocity gradient. But when I try to get the relation this du by dy physically, I know this is the bottom plate, and now the velocity profile I am getting, the linear velocity profile, okay, I am getting here, say the distance between this top plate and the bottom plate is b, and this angle is d theta, dear students, and this is the displacement if I have, okay, it is a s, okay, then you know that velocity is equal to distance divided by time. Distance divided by time. So velocity into time is equal to what? The displacement. And displacement also written as mathematically it is nothing but r theta. R is b into d theta. Yes or no? So here if I write here, velocity into time is equal to b into d theta. So I can write v by b is nothing but d theta by dt. Right? That is this v by b is nothing but what? B is nothing but the y. So here I can write here du by dy. It is not the coefficient of velocity, coefficient of viscosity. Okay, yaha, see, mu is the coefficient of viscosity, that is nothing but your dynamic viscosity, not the velocity. So here du by dy is nothing but, dear students, the rate of change of shear strain. Are you getting my point? So please remember, mathematically it is du by dy, it is a velocity gradient, but you can also write this tau is proportional to this d theta by dt, dear students, rate of change of the shear strain here. Theta is nothing but the shear strain, dear students. Are you getting my point? So this is very important thing, from where you will get this tau is equal to mu into du by dy or mu into d theta by dt. Please remember this. And now you know the actual unit of this mu. Mu is nothing but the dynamic viscosity, dear students. Okay, what is the unit? You know it is Pascal second. Pascal is nothing but the Newton meter square into second, or it is also written by kgs per meter per second. Okay, these are, dear students, the units of the dynamic viscosity. If you divide this viscosity by the density of the material or that fluid, definitely you are going to get the kinematic viscosity. The kinematic viscosity, which is nothing but the mu by rho. Mu by rho, very simple things are there. But dear students, based upon this particular equation, that is the Newtonian fluids, definitely we are going to get. But based on this particular equation, we are getting the so many varieties of the numericals. Okay, that we are going to see. But before that, dear students, we know that this particular relation given with the power law, that is tau is equal to a into du by dy to the power n plus b, which is nothing but the power law. This is nothing but the power law. And you know that if you have different values of this a, b and n, okay, so given these are very simple things, that Poise is what, Stoke is what, we are not going in that particular details. I actually assuming that you are actually through in this particular dimensions and all. Okay, So I'm not actually dealing or not interested at all to go in that particular things. We are actually going for solving the numericals. So quickly just tell me the conditions. When I say A is equal to mu, N is equal to 1 and B is equal to 0, dear students, you will get the very simple relation, that is a Newton's equation, and where you will get this du by dy versus this tau. Okay. What you are going to get? The straight line, yes or no, which is nothing but the Newtonian fluids. This is nothing but the Newtonian fluids, right? Second condition, if I try to take there, that is A is not equal to 0, N is less than 1 and B is equal to 0, dear students, you are going to get the decreasing slope like this, okay, which is nothing but what, dear students, the pseudoplastic fluid, that is blood, paint, lava. For examples, we know blood, paint, lava, okay, aqueous, non-aqueous solutions of the polymers, aqueous and non-aqueous solutions of polymer or suspensions of the polymers. These are, dear students, the examples of the pseudoplastic fluid. Suppose we are having this N in increasing order, that is, you are going to get the graph like this. Okay, so this is nothing but the dilatant fluid, dear students. Okay, for example, butter is the example of dilatant fluid. A is not equal to 0 and N is greater than 1, B is equal to 0. Okay, some aqueous suspension of the magnetite or the galena, aqueous solution of magnetite and galena, or example, you can take the butter. So these are the examples of the dilatant fluids. And finally, dear students, we can have very important relation for the Bingham plastic fluids, which is A is not equal to 0, N is equal to 1 and B is also not equal to 0. You will get this graph like this. Unless and until the applied shear stress reaches to the certain value, there will be no deformation of the fluid. Okay, right. So that is an example. You know that the toothpaste, this is the example. Okay, so from this particular Newton law, the fluid which are following the Newton's law of viscosity, these are known as the Newtonian fluids. These are the Newtonian fluids and others, okay, which are actually not actually obeying the Newton's law of viscosity. That is the non-Newtonian fluids, dear students, which are the dilatant fluid, the pseudoplastic or the Bingham plastic fluids. Right, just see here, the shear stress versus the shear strain, d theta by dt or du by dy. If I plot here, you will get this particular graphs. Very, very important, dear students. Sometimes in the match the pairs, in the some numericals also, they are asking these things. So based on which curve you are getting, you have to identify which kind of fluid is that. Okay, so please, dear students, like the session very fast. Okay, like the session, share the session, and increase the likes, dear students, for this particular session. Take the very first question in this Newton's law of viscosity. Take one question. Very important, because many times you can expect a 2-mark question, dear students, directly from this particular Newton's law of viscosity. Chalo bhaiya, chalo batao jaldi se. A shaft of 80 mm in diameter is being pushed through a bearing sleeve. 80.2 mm in diameter and 0.3 meter long. The clearance is assumed uniform, is flooded with the lubricant of the viscosity 0.1 kgs per meter per second. And the specific gravity is 0.9, that is density will be 900 kgs per meter cube. If the shaft moves axially at a speed of 0.8 meter per second, the axial speed of the shaft is given 0.8 meter per second. Estimate the resistance force exerted by the oil on the shaft. And the second thing they are asking, if the shaft axially fixed and rotated at 1800 rpm, estimate the resisting torque exerted by the oil and the power required to rotate the shaft, dear students. Very simple and very nice question, dear students. So there is a shaft within the sleeve. Okay, let me show you. This is the sleeve, dear students. Sometimes you can call it as it's a journal. Okay, this is the shaft. Okay, and this, between this sleeve and the shaft, dear students, there is what, a layer of this fluid having the viscosity mu, which is equal to 0.1 Pascal second. Okay, so this particular region, if you see here, this yellow color, this is nothing but the sheared area. Okay, between, actually this is the area of the sleeve and the shaft between which you are having this particular fluid. Are you getting my point? So here outer diameter is there. So here if I try to show you, this is the outer diameter of the journal or the sleeve, and in that you are having this shaft, dear student. Okay, and this part is filled with, and this particular region filled with your fluid. Okay, so D outer is there, D outer is there, D inner is there, D inner is nothing but the diameter of the shaft. Okay, so just we have to calculate how much thickness is there, H, H value, how much thickness of the fluid is there in between this gap of outer sleeve and the inner shaft, we have to determine. Okay, so here what are the things they have given? Chalo, jaldi se bata do, dear students, I will write here. So D outer is 80.2, yes or no? So R outer will be how much? 80.2 divided by 2, which is nothing but 40.1 mm. Okay, R inner, shaft radius is how much? Shaft diameter is 80 divided by 2, it will be 40 mm. Okay, length, how much is the length which is going to actually in contact? Yes, this is the length. How much it is given? It is 0.3 meter given, dear students. Check it out. See, 0.3 meter long. Okay, so here I have written L is equal to 0.3 meter. Viscosity 0.1 Newton per meter square, it is second, Newton second per meter square, or it is kgs per meter per second. Okay, the velocity of the axial velocity of the shaft, it is 0.8 meter per second, and density of this fluid is how much? 9 grams per cc, or 0.9 grams per cc, that will be nothing but 900 kgs per meter cube. Very good, dear students. Now you know the Newton's law of viscosity, the shear stress will be what? Is equal to mu into this dv du by dy. Simply I will write this tau is equal to mu into this v by h. Yes or no? And what is the value of h, dear students? The gap, you know, d outer minus d inner divided by 2, that is nothing but the gap. So h will be how much? D outer kitna hai bhaiya? 80.2 minus 80 divided by 2, dear students. So in millimeter I will get 0.1 millimeter. Yes or no? This is the H. Now, dear students, and shear area is how much? You know that the shear stress is equal to shear force divided by shear area, is equal to mu into V by H. Are you getting my point? So tell me here, F is equal to mu into shear area into V upon H. So tell me, mu is how much? Mu is equal to 0.1, dear students. Sheared area, area kitna hai sheared yahan pe batao? It will be this area, this area. This is 2 pi L, 2 pi RL. Are yes or no? 2 pi RL. And here R, from where it is shearing, dear students, on the radius of the shaft, that is RI. Yes or no? So here I will write here, that is F is equal to 0.1 into 2 pi RI into L, okay, into this velocity divided by H. So mu is how much, dear students? 0.1 into 2 pi into RI, 0.04, it is 40 millimeter, so 0.04 meter into 0.3 meter length, and velocity 0.8 meter per second divided by H is how much? 0.1 millimeter, that is 0.1 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. So tell me, dear students, how much is the force? Very important first question we are going to answer now. Tell me how much is the force. The first question we can able to answer now. What they are asking? If the shaft is axial, kaha gaya? If the shaft moves axially with the velocity 0.8 meters per second, estimate the resisting force, dear students. Chalo batao, how much that force? How much is that force? F is how much? Tell me, calculators should be with you, dear students. I am getting here 60.318. 60.318 newton, this is the force, dear students. Getting the force? Chalo bhaiya, chalo jaldi se bata do. Anyone doing the calculation there? Without calculation nothing is going to happen. Please understand this. 60.31, 60.31, and don't go anywhere. Try to see again. We are going to see here the curved, on the curved surface, how to calculate the hydrostatic force. I am going to teach you in this particular session. 60.318, that is absolutely correct. Okay, that is correct, that is correct. Very good. Now, very good. First beat is done. First beat is done. Second beat, what they say? If the shaft is axially fixed, shaft is fixed axially and rotated at 1800 RPM, estimate the resisting torque and your student's power to require to rotate the shaft. Yes, Raj, very correct. So now what we are going to do, dear students, what we are going to do here, my God, see here. So see, now the shaft is going to fix here. And it is rotated at what RPM? N is equal to 1800 RPM. You know, power lost is how much equal to, power is equal to how much? 2 pi nt divided by 60, r omega t omega, that is 2 pi n divided by 60 into t. That is 2 pi n into divided by 60 is okay, but what is the torque? What is the torque? What is torque is nothing but force into radius. Okay, so force is, you know, force is there and this is the radius, dear students. You can able to calculate the torque. You know, V is equal to pi dn divided by 60. You can calculate very nicely. V is equal to pi dn divided by 60. So, diameter is how much? 80 pi into n is how much? 1800 into 10 to the power minus 3. D, which is in millimeter, I converted into meter divided by 60. So, velocity how much? 7.54 meter per second. This is the velocity you are obtaining for this 1800 RPM spindle speed or this job, this shaft speed. Okay, so now you know high, H is how much? H is how much? We have calculated H already. That is 0.1 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. This is the H. And area is how much? Shear area? 2 pi ri into L. So these things are there. That is 2 pi into 0.040 into L is 0.3. If you calculate the shear area, this is nothing but the 0.0754 meter square. Okay, so this is done. Area calculated, velocity known. Okay, now what is our formula? This F is equal to A into mu into V by H. Yes or no? So calculate this F now. The shear area, how much you calculated? Shear area was this much, 0.0754 into mu is 0.1 into velocity calculated 7.54 divided by 0.1 into 10 to the power minus 3. Chalo bhaiya, chalo bata do jaldi se, what is the force here for this RPM 1800? I am getting the force here. If you get force, how much is the force? 568.516 Newton. Check it out. This is the force you are getting, dear students. And now very nicely you can calculate the torque, which is equal to F into R. So F kitna hai? 568.51 into radius 0.040. That is the radius of the shaft. You will get the torque is equal to kitna aa raha hai? 22.74 Newton meter. Check. Very important, dear students. Many times if you go and see, you can get the question in this particular Newton's law of viscosity, that is tau is equal to mu into du by dy. That is a very basic formula. Okay, and now power is equal to what? Yes, power is equal to what? T omega. So power is T, torque is 22.74 into omega 2 pi, n is how much? 1800, okay, divided by 60. Tell me the power. Power is how much kilowatt? I want the answer in the kilowatt, dear students. Chalo jaldi se batao. How much is the answer? 22.74, that is only, see, there are so many students. Okay, I am expecting that everyone actually take the calculator and start doing the calculations. This is the expectation. While sitting for the session, no, see, ideal sitting is not important. Okay, you have to perform here. How much it is? Power, see, I am getting the answer is 4.28. Answer is 4.28128 kilowatt, dear student. This is the answer, correct answer. I hope you are getting 4.28. Absolutely correct, Ankit. Absolutely correct. Very good. So 4.28 kilowatt, that is the correct answer. Very good. Take the next question. A body is weighing, see, tell me very fast, within no time I want the answer, dear students. A body weighing 1000 newton slides on a uniform speed of 1 meter per second along a lubricated inclined plane making angle of. So, Adarsh, if this is the first year, okay, so definitely from your second year, we always welcome you for our platform, okay. So, let us complete the first year, okay, and you can join us from the second year, because see, if in the second year, the subject like fluid mechanics, thermodynamics, strength of material, material science, okay, the soul of engineering is there in the second year and the half of the third year. So definitely, after completion of this first year, you can join us. This is my actually opinion. Chalo bhaiya, chalo jaldi se batao. So the area is also given. The see diagram, you can just have the diagram here. Okay. So very nicely, all the things are shown here. So this is the mg sine theta, which is equal to this viscous force, which is the F. So I will write here F is equal to mg sine theta. Mg, that is weight, directly given 1000 newton sine of 30. This is equation number 1. This is the force. They are asking how much is the thickness of this lubricating film here. Okay. So very nicely, you can write tau is equal to F upon A, which is equal to mu into V by H. Are hai na, they are asking the H. Therefore, I can write H is equal to mu A V divided by F. So mu is how much? 0.1 into shear area. How much? Shear area given, that is 0.25 into velocity 1 meter per second, divided by force is how much? That is 1000 sine of 30. Okay, so tell me H will be how much? H will be how much? So definitely it in meter you will get, but in millimeter if I try to write, I will multiply the 1000 to that meter so that I can get into the millimeter. So it will be 0.05 millimeter, dear students, is the correct answer. 0.05 millimeter, check it out, 0.05 millimeter, you will get the correct answer. That will be the thickness of that, the fluid lubricating film is there, okay, between that plane and this body, okay, which is sliding over there. So see, differentiation and integration, dear students, and the trigonometry, if this is with you, definitely, so all the things are matrices, you know, dear students, that is it is very very basics from the 10th standard we are learning this determinant, matrices, okay. So linear algebra definitely there, the vector, okay, vector calculus, the differential calculus, definitely it is there, as it is 11th 12th, okay. Some the extension of the integration, you are having double integration, triple integration, okay. Again, you are having differential equation also at the next level. Okay, so all the things are there actually. Basically, the extension of all these mathematics from the 12th or 11th standard is there, is present in the degree course. Okay. So, at the moment, others, don't worry about it. Just do your first year very calmly, nicely. And from next, we will talk. Ha, yes, that is meter, dear students. Jeevan Prasad, that is meter. 5 into 10 to the power minus 5. And if you multiply, you convert it into millimeter. So multiply by the 1000, you will get 0.05 millimeter. That is correct. That is correct. That is absolutely correct. Okay, fine. So I hope you are getting this thing. This is the homework. Very fast. This is the homework for you, dear students. Before that, just solve this question so that you can get. Yes, Bhavya, that was in meter, 5 into 10 to the power minus 5, it is in meter, you will multiply by 1000, so it will become 0.05 millimeter, that's it. Mani Selvan, welcome, correct. Neeraj Kumar, Ankit, bahut badhiya. Ramakant, correct answer. So, chalo jaldi se bata do, yahan pe kya kar sakte hum? So, there are the two parallel plates separated by the distance h, and there is again one plate is there, which is at a distance of y from one of the plate. Okay, and the viscosity which is there, the fluid which is there between this particular plates, okay, having the same viscosity, that is mu1, a different viscosity, say mu1 and mu2. Okay, so tell me, not only see this is actually see the Grewal and all these are basically not suitable for you actually. Okay, try to learn from the very basic local publications. If you are actually worrying about the mathematics, try to learn from the simple books. Grewal is the next level here. Okay. So, चलो जल्दी से बताओ आंसर क्या आएगा इसमें से बी सी डी क्या आएगा डियर क्या आएगा. सो यू नो दैट डियर स्टूडेंट्स द एफ अपॉन ए दैट इज शियर स्ट्रेस इज इक्वल टू व्हाट दिस एफ अपॉन ए इज इक्वल टू म्यू इंटू वी अपॉन एच. सो एफ इज इक्वल टू म्यू इंटू ए इंटू वी अपॉन एच. Okay, so F from here and F from here, this is the dear students going to be what? So F is equal to the force from one fluid which is having the kinetic dynamic viscosity mu 1 and the distance y. Okay, I will write here mu 1 into A into V upon this H is nothing but y. H is nothing but y here for this first particular fluid and this is second fluid. Okay. Plus total force if I try to get. So now the second fluid having the viscosity mu 2 into area will be same. Okay, the plate area will be same for top and bottom fluid. Okay, into this V divided by the distance. If this is y, then this will be h minus y. Definitely h minus y, dear student. So area into velocity if I take this area into velocity common, so in the bracket I will get mu 1 divided by y plus mu 2 divided by h minus y is equal to f. So if I want, dear students, this force to be minimum, I have to differentiate the variable is only the length. So I will just tell you if I want to minimize this force, tell me with respect to y and equate to 0, you will get the minimum force. So to get the minimum force, so differentiate this force with respect to y, that is df by dy, and equate to 0, what you will get? So area into velocity common, so into bracket the derivative of 1 upon y is minus this mu 1 upon y square plus the derivative of this 1 upon h minus y, it is minus 1 upon h minus y whole square into coefficient of y is minus 1. Okay, that is this area into velocity is equal to 0, so it is get cancelled out. So it is mu 1 by y square, it is minus plus 1 upon h minus y whole square is equal to 0. This is mu 2, it is mu 2 here. Okay, so tell me here what I can write. So if I write upon y divided by h minus y, therefore I will write y divided by h minus y, it is going to be root over mu 1 divided by mu 2. So see, this is the answer you are getting. See, what is the correct answer? That is y divided by h minus y is equal to what? Root over mu 1 divided by mu 2. This is the correct answer, dear students. Yes, this is the correct answer. And see, this is the question actually depending upon whichever the proof just now we have done, for on that basis only this is the question. I will tell you the answer. This is for homework to you guys. The answer will be 1.71 newton. That is the minimum amount of force which is there onto this plate which is inserted between these two parallel plates. 1.71 newton, it is the correct answer for this particular question. This is the homework. Okay, so dear students, see, in this fashion we are getting the questions, okay, in the examination, right? So I hope, dear students, the Newton's law of viscosity done. This is also the homework question. If you are stucking anywhere, you can just ask me, I will provide you the solution. चलो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन चलो बता दो यहाँ पे वेरी फास्ट. ऑन द मैनोमेट्री वी विल हैव वन क्वेश्चन, सो दैट जस्ट इन द स्टैटिक्स वी विल ओके टू से दैट वी हैव सॉल्व वन क्वेश्चन ऑन द मैनोमेट्री और द प्रेशर मेजरमेंट. चलो भैया बता दो यहाँ पे क्या है. सो हियर द यू ट्यूब बोथ एंड्स आर ओपन एंड फिल्ड विद द मर्क्यूरी एंड ऑब्जर्व 10 सेंटीमीटर अबव द हॉरिजॉन्टल प्लेन. ओके, द इनर डायमीटर ऑफ द ग्लास ट्यूब इज 8 mm. If 19 cc of H2O is added to the one side of the U-bend, the differential or the difference in the mercury level at the equilibrium. So tell me how much it is. So initially it was there a mercury, it was a mercury there, okay, mercury Hg was there. Now due to addition of 19 centimeter cube of the H2O, what will be the small h of the water column? Tell me. So this much, how much h will be there for the water column when you are adding the 19 centimeter cube of water? So when I add 19 cc of H2O, what is the head of that particular water column? Okay, that is V is equal to pi by 4 d square h. Okay, so here if I want to write the h, dear students, so it is 4V divided by pi d square, isn't it? Are hai na? So how much is the volume? 4 into 19 divided by pi into diameter is how much? This is 8 mm, so it is in centimeter, it is 0.8 centimeter square. So what is the height? What is the height there for the h in centimeter? Tell me. Tell me very fast. Anyone is there who can able to answer me? See, initially there was a mercury in this U-tube and now we have added here 19 centimeter cube of H2O. Okay. So they are asking, dear students, the difference in the mercury level at equilibrium when you are adding this particular water of 19 cc. Chalo batao, how much is the H? Whether it is 37.8? Yes, 37.8 centimeter. Okay, that will be the H, students, the height of the water, 19 centimeter or centimeter cube of water which are added in this particular U-tube. Yes or no? So now, dear students, because of this height of the water, there will be the rise of, suppose this was initial level. Now when you added here the water of this 37.8 centimeter, there will be the rise of say x centimeter for the mercury column. Okay, now dear students, when I say that this is at the equilibrium, dear students, that is because of the height of the water, rise in the mercury column by x centimeter, then dear students, if I equate this particular pressures, that is rho w into g into h w is equal to rho of hg into g into h of hg. Dear students, g get cancelled off, rho of water 1 grams per cc into h w is how much? 37.8 centimeter. Rho of hg is 13.6 into h of hg is unknown. Tell me, dear students, h of hg is how much? How much it is? H of hg is how much? Chalo jaldi se. Yes. Pressure in the horizontal plane is same. Yes. That is the same principle we have used here. And now tell me, S1 H1 is equal to S2 H2. Okay, very simple. Tell me very fast. How much should be the rise of the mercury when you added? Yes, dear students, that is 2.78 centimeter of mercury rise. Okay, to get this mercury into the equilibrium, right? Very good. 2.78. very good, dear students. Very good. Excellent. Now, dear students, come to the hydrostatic force on the curved surface. So when you talk about the hydrostatic force onto the curved surface, dear students, there are actually the horizontal force FH, there is a vertical force FV. Okay, and you know that FH can be calculated by gamma times A times X bar or H bar. Okay, where H bar is nothing but, dear students, the centroidal distance from the liquid surface. And dear students, what is A? A is nothing but the projected area. See, I am not interested in the very simple the shapes. Okay, I am interested directly in the curved surface. Okay, so here on the curved surface, we have to calculate the FH, that is the horizontal component of force, and dear students, FV. Okay, which is very important part. The FV can be treated as the weight of the fluid which is standing on the curved surface. Yeah, what is FV? Weight of the fluid standing on curved surface up to free liquid surface. I am telling you, dear students. Yes, mechanical. So mechanical, civil, chemical, for all the students who are there for the fluid mechanics. So I hope there are so many books basically. Local author, public publishers, okay. So mathematics, Nirali publication, if you get, then mathematics by the Kumbhojkar, if you get very, very basics, very nice explanation, okay. And average students can also get it very nicely, okay. So Kumbhojkar and the Nirali publication. Right now, the exact author I don't know, but these are the local publications. Very good. Chalo. So dear students, now see, I am telling you how to actually get the things done here for the curved surfaces. Okay, so now it is very much clear that on the curved surface, this Fv is nothing but how much of the weight of the fluid is there. Okay, from that curved surface up to the free liquid surface. Okay, suppose I am having this curved surface here. Okay, and there is, dear students, liquid here onto this curved surface. Okay, so what the Fv is standing for? So Fv is nothing but, dear students, what is the weight of this particular liquid column which is standing on this particular curve? Okay, no, just Ramakant. Yes, Baijus is there definitely, but he is saying that he is a very actually average candidate in the mathematics. So books he is actually referring for. So he's a first year guy definitely. Okay, so this Fv is nothing but equal to, dear students, what is that? It is nothing but gamma times the volume, dear student. How much volume is there above this curved surface into the gamma, that is rho into g of the substance or the liquid. You can able to calculate this Fv value, that is vertical component of the force. Okay, right? So I will tell you, dear students, how to actually get these things done for this curved surface. For that, I will take one example. See here, one example I have put here. Okay, you can nicely see here. See it here. There is a horizontal cylinder lying horizontally, actually, whose length or the width inside the paper, whose length is inside the paper like this. Okay, and there are the liquid, which is same liquid water from the both of the sides. Okay, there is a water here from full of the diameter, and there is a water again up to the half diameter of the cylinder. Okay, so this particular question I am taking here, and I will be telling you how to get this curved surface done while calculating the hydrostatic force. Okay, so see here, dear students, see, suppose now just forget about the exact values. I am telling you in general how to do all these things. Suppose this is a cylinder, okay, which length is inside the paper. So here you are having the fluids like this. Okay, one side it is complete fluid is there, and the another side, dear students, half of the diameter or half of the height of the cylinder, okay, which is d by 2, and complete diameter, which is d here. Okay, so here the fluid is up to this height, and here fluid is up to complete d height. Okay, here. Now here what to do? I will name this particular cylinder. Okay, I will name the cylinder like this is, say, point 1, this is point 2, this is point 3, and this is point 4. Okay, and the notations are the for the force, right hand, okay, RHS side force is positive, this LHS side force is negative, upside force is positive, and downward force is negative. These are the sign conventions I am using here. Okay, just remember it. Now, dear students, when I take the curve 1 to 2, when I take the curve 1 to 2, okay, I am just calculating the vertical forces, dear students. Horizontal forces, you know how to calculate. Horizontal force, if I calculate here, so Fh1 from this side, that is from left to right, if I take here, which is of course positive force, if I take here, which will be what? I have to take this particular cylinder and project it on the vertical wall. Okay, I will get this particular cylinder like this, where I am having here the height, which is nothing but the diameter. And the centroidal distance, dear students, I am getting here d by 2, which is nothing but my h bar. Okay, so here gamma a h bar, which is nothing but gamma. Area is what, dear students? This is diameter d into width inside the paper is suppose 1 meter, okay, per unit of length. So it will be 1, okay, that is 1 into d into h bar is what? D by 2. So it will be gamma d square by 2. So this is the force, dear students, which is acting on this particular left side of the cylinder, which is gamma d square by 2. Okay, and from the right side, take again the right side, project it on the vertical wall, you will get this particular cylinder of height d by 2. So definitely h bar will be what? D by 4. And your force will be from right to left, this force will be negative force. How much it is? FH2 will be this gamma into width inside paper 1 into d by 2 length into d by 4 is your centroidal distance. Tell me how much is FH2, kitna aya? That is gamma d square by 8, gamma d square by 8, this is your horizontal component of force from right to left. ओके अरे भैया आए कि नहीं समझ में, चलो जल्दी से बताओ फिर क्या होगा. दिस FH नेट विल बी हाउ मच दैट इज FH1 माइनस FH2. टेल मी हाउ मच FH1, दैट इज गामा डी स्क्वायर बाय 2 माइनस दिस इज गामा डी स्क्वायर बाय 8 एंड लेंथ ऑफ कोर्स इनसाइड द पेपर यूनिटी टेल मी इट इज हाउ मच 3/8 गामा डी स्क्वायर. ओके दिस इज द नेट हॉरिजॉन्टल फोर्स डियर स्टूडेंट्स एक्टिंग ऑन दिस सिलेंडर. Okay, horizontal force. Now come to the vertical force, dear students. Okay, so for vertical force, what I have done? I have divided the region of this particular cylinder. Okay, this is one, point number one. This is point number two. This is point number three. Here the liquid is up to this particular height. Here the liquid up to this particular height. Okay, so now just I will take the curved surface 1 to 2, dear students, and what we have said there, that is we are going to take the weight of the liquid which is present there onto this curved surface. Okay, so this is the region. Okay, this is the region where liquid is there onto the curved surface. So where I am going to get this FV, suppose FV 1 to 2, I want to calculate FV vertical force 1 to 2. Tell me, it is nothing but what? It is nothing but, dear students, this particular gamma into what? Volume. So which volume, dear students? It may be real volume or imaginary volume. Just from that curved surface we have to take. So here point 1, it is there, it is already on the free surface. Now from 2, I will go to the free liquid surface and here I will stop, unless and until I will reach to the free liquid surface. So this much volume I want, dear students. Okay, one already on the surface of this fluid, and second I just take the point second, and from second I come upward direction up to the free liquid surface and I am getting this particular volume. So how to get this volume? So can I have the square of radius, say r by r square is there. So this r by r square minus if I have the wall, this particular area, this quadratic or this quarter circle if I have here, okay, which is pi r square by 4 into L. L is inside the paper. Can I get this particular volume which is there on the curvature 1 and 2? Yes. That is gamma times, see here, this gamma times V, which is nothing but gamma into this area of square minus area of this quarter circle, okay, into L. Quarter circle. It is a cylinder. Okay. So this area is how much? Gamma into R by R minus area of the quarter circle pi R square by 4 into this length of the cylinder inside the paper L. So dear students, see, this is my FV 1 to 2. Yes. And how it is? It is acting on to the curved surface from top to bottom. So it is negative. So it is going to be negative, dear students. It is going to be the negative. Okay, now come to the second point, dear student, that is second curvature. So curvature from where to where? Point 2 to 3, and here is a free liquid surface. Okay, so again from 3, chalo, let us come up to the surface of the liquid. So here I started from the point 3. Now I am coming to the point here, free liquid surface. Again from point 2, I will start and I will come onto the free liquid surface. So this much region, dear students, this much is the volume I am having on this curved surface 2 to 3. Okay, so tell me the FV on 2 to 3 will be how much? And it is of course the thrust force I am getting here. from bottom to top. Tell me how much it is. So it is nothing but what? It is nothing but the square, this r by r, this is r by r, plus the quarter circle pi r square by 4. Yes or no? So gamma into volume is how much? This r by r plus the quarter circle pi r square by 4, which is the area, and I want volume, so multiply by the length inside the paper. So this is nothing but the force, vertical force onto the curve 2 to 3, and which is what? Buoyant type of force, which is a positive from bottom to top. It is acting like this. Yes or no? Very easy, dear students, very easy, right? So this is the force, vertical force on 2 to 3, and now finally, dear students, if I get the vertical force on 3 to 4 is here, 3 to 4 is here, and liquid is up to this. So this is, dear students, the volume. So it is gamma times volume. What is the volume of this? It is a quarter circle. So gamma into pi r square by 4 into, this is the area, then volume will be what? Into the length. So it will be gamma times pi r square by 4 into L. So this is what again, dear students? Positive. This is the positive force, Fv 3 to 4. And this is how, dear students, the Fv net force, if I want to get here, so it will be what? So this first force is this negative Fv 1 to 2. I'll write negative Fv 1 to 2. Then, dear students, positive Fv 2 to 3 plus positive Fv 3 to 4. This will be the net Fv you are going to get. And finally, dear students, you will be get the resultant force, which is equal to root over Fh net square plus Fv net square. So this is the resultant force, and you will get it here, somewhere here. That is the resultant force, R with an angle alpha. Okay. Okay, are you getting my point? So this is kind of buoyancy only, no? So which is nothing but the upward thrust which is acting on this particular curvature from liquid onto the curved surface. Okay, you directly see, if you say it buoyancy, because it is buoyancy only. Otherwise, you simply say the force which is acting on the curvature and direction is upward. So you can say it is positive. No any chance of confusion. This is very simple fashion. I am telling you how to calculate the forces on the curved surface. Okay, so take, these are the examples, dear students. So I will solve all these questions. See, we are not having time. So see here. Now suppose this is the question. They are asking what is the vertical force, okay, which is acting there onto this hemispherical or spherical viewing port is there. So come on, this is the spherical viewing port. So it is projected area will be the circle. So Fh will be what? Gamma A H bar. So gamma is how much? Gamma into area is how much? Pi R square into H bar is how much? 1.5 plus this one, it will be 2.5. So tell me how much it is. So it is 9810 into pi into radius is 1 square into 2.5. You will get Fh is equal to 77.04 kilonewton. This is the Fh. Now come to the Fv calculation. So what you will do, dear students? For the Fv calculation, this is the hemispherical port is there. Okay. So now, suppose I number 1, 2 and this is number 3. So if I get the first curvature, that is Fv on curvature 1 to 2, which is acting like this. Okay. Which is negative. From top to bottom, it is negative. And now, if I take the curvature 2 to 3, so it is nothing but the positive. Okay. So now, dear students, see here, this is nothing but, this is the region above the curve 1 2, this is the volume, it's nothing but, dear students, I'm going to get the force for that volume, multiply this specific weight gamma. Okay, now here, suppose if I'm now, what is the net force I'm going to get? That is Fv 2 to 3 minus F from Fv 1 to 2. So this is nothing but what? From this particular region, if I subtract this particular thing, okay, from this entire region, that is this, okay, I subtract this, just this region, it is nothing but what? Ultimately, sphere is there. Okay, because this minus this, okay, it is the spherical port is left over there only. So I will get the only volume of the spherical port. That is nothing but FV. Okay, so FV will be how much? Gamma times volume of spherical port. So this gamma is 9810 spherical port. Half the spherical port is there. That is 2 by 3 pi r cube. 4 by 3 pi r cube is the complete area of volume for the sphere. Here it is half. So tell me it is how much? 9810 into 2 pi by 3 into r is how much? 1 cube. It is going to be 20.55 Newton. This is the net vertical force, dear students, acting onto this spherical port. And you will get now the result that will be root over FH square plus FV square. It is near about 79.74 kilonewton. Are you getting my point? So see here what I did here. This is the spherical port. So this is 1 to 2, 2 to 3 if I divide. Now for the first curvature it is 1 to 2. Here it is the volume of the fluid which is above this curve. Okay. So this is actually force is going to be like this, FV1. And when I take 2 to 3 curvature, so this is the volume, entire volume, okay, is there for 2 to 3 curve, which is positive. FV2 will be what? 2 to 3 will be what? Positive. So when I add these, that is FV2 minus FV3, algebraic summation I am going to take. So definitely from this entire, suppose this is ABCD, ABCD, from this entire ABCD, you just minus this ABED. If I minus or subtract from this ABCD, so it will be this particular volume only, which is nothing but the spherical volume. Okay. So that is the reason why only I took here the volume of the spherical port. Okay, so try to understand, try to understand. Okay, I hope you can get the question done here. How much is the answer? 20 point, how much is? 20.55 is the vertical force. And finally, overall force, dear students, it is resultant force, which is there, 79.74. So these are the questions. Take it, these questions for the homework. Okay, see, we actually understand something and then we try to solve the question. So definitely, dear students, now here, whenever you are measuring the gauge pressure and you want the absolute pressure, definitely some atmosphere should be there to calculate the gauge pressure. Yes or no? So here, if I try to get the absolute value for the N gauge, so it will be gauge pressure of this N plus whichever the adjacent atmospheric pressure is, how much? 750 mm of H. So I have to add there, I have to add there that 750. So it will be P atmospheric is nothing but 750 mm of atmospheric. So if I calculate this PN, okay, absolute, that will be around 135 kilopascal, dear students. Okay, now when I go for having the pressure, the absolute pressure at M, so the gauge pressure of M plus absolute pressure of this, what the surrounding is for N. Yes or no? So here I will get the pressure of M is equal to PN, okay, which is nothing but the atmospheric pressure for the M plus the gauge pressure of the M, dear students. So that will be the M, how much it is? 20,000 Pascal plus this 135,000 Pascal. It will be 155 kilopascal. So very simple, very simple. Whenever gauges, see, for gauge always giving you the gauge reading, of course. To convert this gauge reading into absolute, you have to take the surrounding atmospheric pressure in addition to that, and that will be the absolute pressure. So see here, for N the surrounding is the atmosphere, for M the surrounding for the pressure of N. So like that you can get the values of pressure in kilopascals for M and N. Absolute value, absolute pressure they are asking, absolute. Okay. So just take it homework, take this question as a homework for the forces on the curved surface. Okay, take this questions as a homework. I will provide you the solution. Don't worry, I will upload the solution on my Telegram channel definitely. Just after completion of this session, I will upload these solutions. Okay, this question also very simple. My aim was that just to understand the forces on the curved surfaces. See, these are the questions. Okay, I hope you can able to solve these questions. Now you can able to solve these questions, and I will upload the solutions. Don't worry, I will upload the solutions. Okay, so next session, dear students, we will be learning the kinematics and dynamics. Kinematics and dynamics. So dear, see, understand, the buoyancy and all is a part of the statics, Ramakant. Not each and every topic, whichever topic we choose, we will clearly understand it and solve it. Suppose if I take buoyancy here, so definitely only buoyancy I discuss. Okay, I will upload the PDF. I will upload the PDF. Okay, so see, syllabus is quite very huge, but out of that, we just trying to get the probable things here. Okay, and some of the things I left on you that you can able to understand very nicely by your own. These are very simple things. Okay, thank you so much, dear students. So like the session, share the session, and subscribe our channel. Don't forget to do that. Right. Okay, we will meet day up to tomorrow in the next session for the kinematics and dynamics. Okay. Yes, Ramakant. I'm not telling that each and every topic I'm going to complete here. Please understand. Whichever the important that I feel, okay, those topics we will understood nicely and solve the questions on that. Okay, thank you so much for joining the session. Tomorrow you can meet me at 10 a.m. okay, on the Byju's app, where MSQ sessions are going on for the production engineering. So tomorrow's topic is metal forming, dear students, metal forming. If you are mechanical engineer, definitely metal forming is tomorrow 10 a.m. on the Byju's app. Okay, thank you so much. Bye bye, take care. Jai Hind.